can sing it at like my voice talking to you, and it just comes out so easy.
Yeah.
And to hit that range.
It's big. It's a big range. It's a vast amount of notes, and it spans from one style of his voice, which was very early, sort of bubblegum pop, doo-wop, and it goes into the more rock, edgy, later late 60s, early 70s Frankie Valli with, you know, the big hits. So, yeah, it's a lot. It's a lot to do, but I do it.
So how did you get to here? I know, tell us a little bit about your experience going to Frankie Camp and meeting Frankie.
Yeah, it's a long journey, and it happened in 2007, and it's 2011 now, so it's been a long time, and I really feel very comfortable in this role, and I really feel confident in what I do, what we all do as a cast, an ensemble, the crew, everyone. It's a well-oiled machine, but it's not by rote. We still, like, breathe new life into it every night, and really we have a lot of care and passion for what we do. But the road to get to being on stage in Jersey Boys was long. And my journey was shorter than most. It was, I auditioned in May in Los Angeles, and I had many auditions and many callbacks, and they took me to New York, and I had many auditions and many callbacks, and that's where you have what's called Frankie Camp. And Frankie Camp at the time was not as illustrious as it is now. The phrase wasn't coined, and it wasn't this hot topic to talk about, but now it is, and you know, a lot of guys have gone through it, and very few graduate, you know, from camp and go on to play the role. They just have that. That's their Jersey Boys experience. They get to go to camp. Well, I got to go to camp, and then I got to go be in the show, and that's been really amazing. So without boring you with details, that's how I got here. Yeah.